It's June 23rd, 1997, and this is episode 215 of WWF Monday Night Raw. Commentary for the night is Vince McMahon and JR. Raw opens with a new Nation of Domination making their way to the ring. Vince starts off by asking Ahmed Johnson why he joined the Nation of Domination. Ahmed turns on the fans and says that they didn't back him, and that's why he joined the Nation of Domination, because they have his back. And in regards to The Undertaker, Ahmed says he doesn't have respect for The Undertaker anymore, because he's nothing but a slave to Paul Bearer. D'Lo Brown grabs the mic and says that Vince and the fans turned their back on Ahmed Johnson, and that's why he's with us. Farouk then says that he got rid of the previous members of the Nation of Domination because they just couldn't get the job done. But now, with the new nation, you will see the job getting done, by any means necessary. Carmen Mustafa then gloats about beating the WWF Champion Undertaker last week on Raw. The Nation is then interrupted by Crush. Crush confronts Farouk and introduces Farouk to his new faction, the Disciples of Apocalypse, or DOA. Crush says they live together, they ride together, and they fight together. And the DOA attack the Nation.
A new nation! Fine! Nothing more than a game fight!
Trying to maintain order here!
The two groups brawl until police separate them.
Trying to straighten things out.
You gotta believe, folks, our plans to come right here tonight and come to the ring.
After the brawl, we head backstage to the Legion of Doom. The LOD cut a quick promo addressing their match later tonight with the Godwins. Now for the first match of the night, Rockabilly with the Honky Tonk Man is taking on Ken Shamrock. Dan Severn joins the announcer's table to call this match.
Right here in this very arena, I believe, in which, would you grant that? We're going to change your headset here. We've got some audio difficulties. He is of late kind of falling on hard times, but to a certain extent, it was a nice takedown.
Okay, he's going right into an ankle submission lock there. Right? Severn, how about Ken Shamrock? He.
From behind. Uh-oh, look out for the ride.
Very powerful belly to belly.
Well, there you go for it right there, right?
He's got that ankle.
Shamrock wins the match with the ankle lock. After the match, Shamrock heads to the announcer's table to face off with Dan Severn. The two then shake hands. Next, we cut backstage to the Godwins. Henry Godwin is out for revenge against the LOD tonight, as last time these two teams met, Henry was injured at the hands of the LOD. Henry says that tonight, what happens to the LOD won't be an accident, and that the Godwins are doing things their own way now. The next match is a tag team title quarterfinal match. The Legion of Doom are taking on the Godwins. The Godwins waste no time and slot the LOD at ringside.
Oh no! How humiliating!
And justifiably so! The Godwins
by the Hart Foundation, and we'll keep you updated what it would be.
Oh! Come up close, take to the midsection, hold up!
For the Ninja Girl! Deep in the Ozarks.
And look out the pile driver! And to the midsection, Phineas! Down with the neck cracker! Goes to work now. Animal over the top rope. And oh no!
The revenge factor in this matchup.
Here we go, boom! Clothesline there. Look at all four men.
Oh yeah!
At the same time. Well, now there's a Hawk from the top.
Hawk wins the match with a flying clothesline on Henry Godwin. After the match, the Godwins attack the LOD. Animal cleans the ring with a chair, but the Hart Foundation would run in and continue the attack on the LOD.
The Hart Foundation! Up on the stage! Surveying this!
Red Hart! Look at this! Looking on from a distance! Right now, ladies and gentlemen!
After a commercial break, we head backstage with The Undertaker and Paul Bearer. The Undertaker attempts to speak, but he's cut off by Paul Bearer. Having endured this for weeks now, The Undertaker grabs Bearer by the throat. Vader runs in to help, but The Undertaker also grabs him. The Undertaker ultimately lets Bearer and Vader go, as Bearer reminds The Undertaker of the secret he's holding over his head. We then cut to Owen Hart. Owen isn't happy about his upcoming match tonight, where he will have to defend his Intercontinental title against both Hunter Hearst Helmsley and Goldust in a triple threat match. Owen says that it's a conspiracy that he, as a Canadian, has to defend against two Americans on American soil. We then head backstage to Flash Funk. Flash Funk cuts a quick promo on Sabu before their match. We then cut to the announcer's table where Vince McMahon and JR are joined by Paul Heyman. Now for the next match, Flash Funk is taking on Sabu with Bill Alfonso.
Paul said he's got scars all over himself.
This man has paid a price that very out question. Watch this!
Ladies and gentlemen, uh-oh, look at this.
El Sabu, oh! Take it!
Somersault plot to my Sabu!
He is going to put Flash Funk through a table!
Ron, live, uh-oh.
Whoa, what a maneuver now!
Look at this.
What a hurricane runner!
This is one unbelievable athlete.
Twice.
Oh, there you go.
Whoa, what a clothesline.
Kick with this.
And oh, yeah. Great pitcher, great march. Look out, Flash coming to town.
And your man gets brought to the extreme. You're seeing a whole kiss-ass Taz, who is
from the top and down.
Right to Raw.
Oh, look at that maneuver. Great move. Great...
With the two brawling on the outside, the match would end in a double countout.
Oh, no. Oh.
Take that.
No. I think it killed him.
Moving to the next match, the European champion, the British Bulldog, is taking on Mankind in a non-title match. Mankind has recently been asking Steve Austin to pick him as his tag team partner. Once in the ring, Mankind dedicates this match to Steve Austin.
Mankind is a little different, isn't he?
During the match, Vince connects with Steve Austin over the phone. Austin addresses Mankind lobbying to be his tag team partner. Austin then says that it's not his decision and that Shawn Michaels holds the other tag team title. And quite frankly, he could give a damn about Mankind.
Kobe's here, I've got him over here, my wife is rock out, whip your ass.
The top boat back to the outside.
We're in his clothesline looking for the mandible claw in this non-time Austin.
And oh no! Tension! Oh no!
Mankind and mandible claw. He's still sick. He still needs help.
You want to gain respect from his peers. Look at this. Here we go. No. Mankind has that claw.
Bulldog hits Mankind with a low blow to get out of the mandible claw. Bulldog would then get himself disqualified after attacking Mankind with a chair.
The Bulldog into the back.
Mankind is getting waylaid. He hit right in the face of that chair.
After the attack, Mankind would recover and lock in the mandible claw on Bulldog.
He's got it. That mandible claw down in the gullet of the British Bulldog in the
Bulldog luckily escapes.
One that was tough. He couldn't choose one that's tough.
After a commercial break, we cut backstage to Owen Hart, where he is complaining to Gorilla Monsoon. Owen is telling Gorilla Monsoon that it's not fair that he has to take on two men tonight, and that he wants to have Brian Pillman in his corner. Monsoon allows Owen to have Brian Pillman in his corner. Next up is a triple threat match for the WWF Intercontinental title. Owen Hart with Brian Pillman is defending against Hunter Hearst Helmsley with China and Goldust with Marlena. Pat Patterson is a special guest referee.
Pat Patterson! You finish that match because no one individual.
The champion, you can't coach. You can't here in the WWF.
And this one likely to get out of line. Oh, high knee by Hunter Hearst.
First man, doesn't matter who it is, whether a pinfall or a championship is vacant going into the match.
Champion to be the champion.
Yes, it's an unusual set of men. The champion can't take.
So now when Hunter Hearst does, what a suplex match played up to be. Wearing the gold again. Hunter Hearst Helmsley. Look out, here comes the pedigree. No!
Spinning heel kick by Owen.
And no!
That's it!
Goldust hits the curtain call on Owen and pins Owen for the win. But Owen's foot was on the ropes here. Pillman gets into the ring to argue with Pat Patterson. But Patterson isn't reversing the decision. El Hebner heads down to protest. And Gorilla Monsoon would head down and restart the match.
Over. Unlucky for Goldust and very lucky for
Battle.
Goldust now down.
He'll flip-flop and fly.
Goldust wants it and he wants it badly. Owen Hart and the Hunter Hearst. Intercontinental champion and history being made here tonight. And here we go. Can he get it in? Cinch it in and oh.
Usual matchup.
A triple threat matchup, but not forcing to do so. Oh. A shot there. Oh, no. Oh, my. Oh. Someone's going to walk out of Detroit as the Intercontinental. Owen Hart!
Drop kick! Double drop kick!
Goldust off the rope! Pinning heel kick! Owen Hart! And there's China! China!
Oh! China!
Triple threat! Trying to come in!
It's a third
tap! Oh! Oh, did you? Goldust landing!
Owen Hart retains the Intercontinental title after capitalizing on Goldust's top rope dive onto Helmsley. After a commercial break, Bret Hart heads down to the ring with Jim Neidhart. Bret addresses the Hart Foundation's upcoming match at the Canadian Stampede. He cuts a short promo on all five opponents, Goldust, the LOD, Ken Shamrock, and Steve Austin. Bret says that they will not steal a victory from them in Canada. Bret then looks to the crowd and calls out Thomas Hitman Hearns, for calling himself the Hitman. Hearns is a professional boxer, with title wins in five different weight classes. Hearns eventually gets into the ring after Bret continues to taunt him. Bret gets ready for a fight, and Hearn takes out Jim Neidhart. Referees and agents are quick to get in between Bret and Thomas Hearns. After a commercial break, we head backstage to Farouk and the Nation of Domination. As Farouk begins to address his upcoming match with The Undertaker and Vader later tonight, he's interrupted by Savio Vega. Vega tries to attack Farouk, but the Nation would stop him and they'd all beat him down. We then cut to a pre-recorded promo with Brian Christopher, where he speaks about his arrival in the WWF, stating that he'll make an impact in the WWF light heavyweight division. Next up, future tag team partners are in action. Scott Taylor is taking on Brian Christopher with Jerry Lawler. Jerry Lawler joins the commentary team for this match.
Going to make a tremendous impact. Brian commentary, no one less than
only King McMahon. Right. And I want to tell you something. I sat back and I listened to this garbage. Well, Brian Christopher from the USW.
From the looks of things, Brian Christopher. Oh, tremendous athlete. Matchup, ladies and gentlemen. Brian Crow.
Now, how do you know when somebody's lying if your lips are moving?
Well, speak and claim that Brian Christopher is your son.
Kick butt.
The acorn
doesn't fall far from the tree.
Brian Christopher wins the match with a diving leg drop. After a commercial break, we head backstage to Paul Bearer with Vader. Bearer says that everything is fine after the issue he had earlier tonight with The Undertaker. The next match is a tag team title quarterfinal match. The Nation of Domination are taking on The Undertaker and Vader with Paul Bearer. Ahmed Johnson is shown watching the match backstage, and we're told that Ahmed may have injured his knee in the brawl earlier with the DOA.
Against the Godwins on Raw. Yes, The Undertaker and Vader having words, and look out, here we go. And again, you sort of wonder. Is Ahmed back there?
During the match, the Disciples of Apocalypse head down to the ramp.
Who was fired by the Nation of Domination?
Here we go!
The DOA attack D'Lo and Farouk, but the Undertaker joins into the brawl with the DOA as well. The referee does not call off the match here.
Stay with us, ladies and gentlemen!
After a commercial break, the DOA have left ringside, and the match is continuing.
Oh! Momentum, if he can hit it, and no! What a very bad knee. He blew out a knee earlier on.
Right under the Black Valley look.
During the match, we cut to Bearer and The Undertaker arguing. Vader attempts to tag in The Undertaker, but Undertaker hits Vader in the face, allowing Farouk to hit a clothesline for the win. After the match, Vader attacks The Undertaker before he can leave the ring. And The Undertaker would hit Vader with a tombstone piledriver. He'd then pursue Paul Bearer.
Tombstone, and now it's Paul!
Bearer would then leave the ring before The Undertaker could get to him. As Undertaker is leaving the ring, Bearer gets on the mic. Bearer says that The Undertaker has made his casket, and now he's gonna have to lie in it. And says that he will reveal The Undertaker's secret next week on Raw. The Undertaker stands on the ramp and sends a warning to Bearer. Raw would then end with Bearer arguing with the cameraman, not wanting to be filmed. Before we finish, please comment on your favourite part of the show. Mine was The Undertaker walking out on Paul Bearer. Thank you so much for watching. If you haven't yet, please subscribe to the channel, leave a thumbs up if you enjoyed the video, if not a thumbs down, and I'll see you on the next one.